I began to get so cramped in things. I said, why is it all of a sudden things are not going well? God, I obey you. You said this and I did. You said this and I did. But and all of a sudden, things begin to get normal again. Mm-hmm. But the moment I begin to pray unto him, he checked my record and said, this person is obedient. Why not? Here you are. So the more you are obedient to God, the more he opens up avenues for you. That's what we call blessings. Amen.
Amen.
When we obey God, we can live a life of joy without shame, rooted deeply in the Lord Jesus Christ, and are confident of eternal hope. Because when you obey God, you live life without shame and also stress. For example, you were a student. You are about to enter into college. The Bible says, thou shalt not commit fornication. You committed it. This girl is now pregnant. It's your responsibility to stop your schooling and take care of her. Instead of all your mates are studying to become doctors and lawyers, you have to cut your education short and go to the fabric to do 13 hours a day. How long will you live? So when you see your mates in the Mercedes Benz, you are now chasing the tram. All because you disobey the voice of God that says, thou shalt not fornicate. God's laws are not to restrict you and not to impede you to make you feel uncomfortable, but for your own protection. Amen.
Yeah.
You know why I don't smoke? You know why I don't drink? I want to preserve my lungs and my destiny intact. Because I want to live long. God forbid that I die 45 years old and when I go, God forbid. I won't die too early. So I have to preserve what is inside of me. So when God says, don't drink alcohol, I say, yes, sir, God. Yes, sir. I don't need to ask him questions. Why not? Take this. Who has a car here? You have a car, right? You have a car? You have a car? Yes. Who has a car? Good. What fuel does your car use? Benzene. Or diesel?
Benzene.
Unglorified and negative. And the man, what is your car that you do you use? Opel Corsa. When the man who made Opel Corsa was making it, were you there? No, you were not there. But when he went and buy the car, he said, this car only uses benzene. And so, Mr. Opel, you are Kolo. Me, I am PIWC Antwerp member, a tenant member. I don't listen to you, so I said, I don't know. I love coffee. I hope you have put coffee in my car. What's the problem? That Mr. Opel tell about you? No. You wake up to go to your work and your car wouldn't start.
Yes.
And you'll be late and your boss will fire you. Is that Mr. Opel's problem? No. But his principle is that use benzene. And you say you like coffee, success. That's how God is. God's principles are principles. Obey them and be free. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm about to finish. Our obedience is actually part of our assurance that we truly know God. So if you say somebody will do something, say, you say you were a Christian, but look at what you are doing. If somebody says, don't you feel ashamed? Yeah, you go to a party and you see a PWC member wearing a skirt up to here and no, somebody say, are you a Christian? But look at the way you dressed. Does the Bible say you should do so? And you become cold. You know what I'm talking about. So whenever you obey God's word, he gives you the freedom to do anything that nobody will even question you about. Amen.
Amen.
Last but not the least, it brings God's reward. It brings who? God's reward. When Samuel obeyed God's word, Hophni and Phinehas, who were the sons of Eli, who were disobeying God, the Bible says they died at the battlefield. They perished. But Samuel grew very old. He was respected. Everybody revered him. The same thing applies to you today. If you will be attentive to God's word that you read every day, people will respect you. When they are coming to you, they are coming to speak to you in dignity and in respect. I'm not sure nobody will step up to others and say, oh, man, I hope I'm being busy, I'm going to be my life. No, you won't do that. You respect the man of God. Why? Because he obeys God's word. Amen.
Amen.
As I bring the message to an end, Today is the Lord's Supper. Jesus says something in John, take your Bible with me this time. John chapter 6, verses 53. John 6, 53. Who is there can read with me, please? John 6, 53.
John chapter 6, verse 53. Jesus said to them,
slowly, don't rush.
Jesus said to them, I tell you the truth. Unless you can eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you.
Amen. Jesus said unto them, surely, surely, I say unto you today, PRWC turnout, unless you eat the flesh and drink of the blood, you have no what? Life in you. But I will not eat, I will not die. After all, I go to my school tomorrow. That's what the physical death is talking about. He's talking about your spiritual death. So now, if you obey God's word, you die with him as he has said. The life you are going to have is that you're going to have your spirit having contact with him. Okay? Right now, if I get outside there, I take a brown leaf. And I take from the tree a green leaf. Are they equal or they are not equal? Why are they not equal? The brown one is there and the green one is fouled. Give all of the two 2 hours. The green one will be brown. Why? Because it has detached itself from the tree, from the source. And the two of them will die. They are dead. So that's why Jesus is saying.
So next yourself.
Why not? Thank you, madam. So that's what Jesus is saying. If you eat my flesh and drink my blood, you have life. That means you touch yourself with the tree. But if you disobey me, you don't die with me, there's no life. You become like the green tree, the green leaf that has been plucked off the tree. In a matter of time, it will die. So today we thank God so much for what he has said before us. Because it's not everybody who has a chance to die with God. I remember back in Genesis, the Bible says, when they have taken the fruit and they ate it, their eyes were what? Open. Phew! Oh, you are naked. How can it happen? So all along I was naked and I didn't see. Oh, now I'm naked. What happened? They ate the fruit and they were naked. While Elder was leading us in prayer, he quoted from Luke chapter 4. When he says, drown with them, their eyes did what? Is there any difference between the eye open in Genesis chapter 3 and the eye open in Luke chapter 4? Luke 24. Is there any difference? After all, eye be eye. But listen, when Jesus opens your eye, your heart becomes joyful. When the devil opened the eyes of our grandfather and grandmother in the Garden of Eden, they became rebellious and they ran away from God. But when he says open your eyes, you run to God. Today is my prayer that as we time with the Lord, our eyes will open. Amen. You will not run away from God as Adam and Eve did, but you will run towards God and embrace him. May the peace of God that transcends all understanding be with your hearts and minds in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.